Greetings and welcome to Franz's Fine Dining. This is Yo Sushi. It's a restaurant specializing in a modern type of sushi service called conveyor belt sushi, or kaiten-zushi as it's called in Japan. This place is actually part of a chain of not only sushi restaurants, but also hotels, which, despite their Japanese trappings, are owned and operated out of the UK by a British entrepreneur whom I guess is particularly fond of Japan. Now, ordinarily, I do this series to highlight food of particular quality or value. This episode is a little bit different because what I'm trying to show here is the establishment itself, since conveyor belt sushi restaurants tend to be pretty uncommon outside of Japan and are relatively difficult to find in other countries. I'm going to be talking about the food momentarily, but before anything else, I wanted to show really the highlight of the entire establishment, which is this conveyor belt. The conveyor belt carries a number of different dishes of different types of sushi around the room, and the idea here is whatever dish you want, you just take, and then at the end of the meal, your order and the price are totaled up based on the number of dishes and their color. There are little buttons at each station, which when you press them, will change the color of one of these lights to indicate to a server that you'd like to place an order. As for the food itself, this is I believe a fritter of some kind, like a tempura fritter, filled with grated taro, which is a type of Japanese yam. One of my guests ordered that, so I can't speak to its flavor. This is an order of gyoza, a rather disappointingly small order of gyoza, which you've probably seen in dozens of other similar videos. And this is a bowl of ramen, which again, I did not order, but I am told by my guest who did order it that it was a filling and appetizing portion of ramen. It looks about par for the course, and I can vouch for its size in person. This, I think, was about $10, so it looked like a reasonable portion. This I did order, and while it was very delicious, it was the saddest and most overpriced and tiniest order of takoyaki that I have ever had. Typically, when you order these from street vendors in Japan, you get at least 6 fairly large pieces. Here, I got 3 very small ones. And the same deal with this. This is a sort of contemporary take on a Chinese steamed bun called baozi. And this particular one had a lobster tail in it, but it was a tiny, tiny portion for $8. That was literally 2 bites. And then, of course, a cup of green tea, which I can't go without at restaurants like this. So the food here is hit or miss, and you do have to be careful what you order, because it's possible to get a reasonably priced meal here, but you generally have to stick to the ramen or the conveyor belt. And so if you're really hungry and you're okay with just eating some cheaper sushi, you can come to a place like this and load up on the $3 and $5 plates and walk away full without breaking the bank. But you do have to be careful of the appetizers here, because many of them seemed to be really very overpriced for very small amounts of food. The quality was fine. They tasted good, but $8 is still way too much for a baozi that's small enough to fit in the palm of my hand, lobster or no lobster. They do also seem to serve alcohol here, although I don't drink, so I can't vouch for the prices or the quality of the drinks that they serve here. But it's neat just to come here to check it out and to order a few plates of sushi. So that's it. I hope you've all enjoyed this. I'm really glad I finally had a chance to show one of these places. And I look forward to seeing all of you next time. Take care, everyone.